If Equatorial Health Warning is not working in Indonesia, please call Rubariski. Second information. He also mentioned in his presentation quitline. The I'm dirihor to Ibu Sandra. So if quitline is not working in Indonesia, please call Ibu Sandra. I hope the telephone numbers should be publicized because they are public figures. With this, I would like to just again highlight here the thank you very much for the clear roadmap of Ministry of Health to increase the size of Equatorial Health Warning to 75% and also going beyond the 75% that is the plain practice. So, I just would like to repeat this slide. Our future is not written. The future of our children hasn't been written by anyone. So, it's a we have to write our future, the future of our generation, and future of our country. So, we are responsible to change the public health, the scenario in Indonesia. So, for Ridwan, the presentation clearly identified the Indonesian, majority of the Indonesians support Equatorial Health Warning. The larger Equatorial Health Warning, they are in favor of the Equatorial Health Warning, larger number. So it's a real wonderful result. So we need Equatorial Health Warning to make a very simple education, communication, and information to our people to help them to quit smoking, to help them to discourage smoking, to help our children to discourage the picking up their smoking, and to really create a healthy environment wherever we go, wherever we stay. So, at the global level, if you look at Indonesia is not alone. The whole global communities are really serious implementing the Equatorial Health Warning intervention in their own country. If you look at by 2017, more than 100 countries are implementing the Equatorial Health Warning. The second one, larger graphic health warning, more than the 90 countries are implementing the more than 50% Equatorial Health Warning at the global level. So what does it mean? It means Equatorial Health Warning is one of the most cost-effective interventions for our society. So it's in Indonesia, they are very effective. So you have seen this slide in the recent presentation as well. In South and South Asia, Nepal is leading with a 90% Equatorial Health Warning, and we are here again with 40%. In part, the Ridwan presentation, Indonesia would like to see 90% Equatorial Health Warning on the secret path. So the Ministry of Health plan is 75% by 2019, and then the plan package. That's a really good opportunity for Rishi, Ibu Sandra, and for all of us to increase the size from 40% to more than 90%, or going beyond 90% to be the leader at the global level. Now the question is, are these Equatorial Health Warnings effective? Ridwan has mentioned the public opinion poll, what happening in Indonesia, what level of support from the people regarding the Equatorial Health Warning. Thus, I would like to show you some the evidence from other countries in Asia Pacific. Most of these countries in Asia Pacific have been implementing larger graphic health warning for a few years. Nepal implementing 90%, Thailand and India, they are implementing 85%. Sri Lanka is implementing 80%, and now they are moving forward for clean packaging this year. Myanmar just started last year with a 75% Equatorial Health Warning, and this year on June 5, on next month, June 5, Myanmar is going to sign a 90% Equatorial Health Warning. The Ministry of Health made a already commitment, already announced the date as well. So the Brunei are implementing 75%, Laos are implementing 75%, and Malaysia also. So there are the several countries around us already doing the larger drive. Just for very quick, this is a bit 2015 survey. in Nepal and Indonesia. We have used the very similar methodology in both countries. And Nepal has implemented 90% Victoria Health Warning in 2014. Very similar time also in Indonesia, 40% Victoria Health Warning. What happened? If you look at this, in Indonesia, yes, Victoria Health Warnings are effective. The question is that to the smoker, whether they have there was any effect of Victoria Health Warning to encourage them to quit or to reduce the number of cigarettes that they consume per day. So in Indonesia, before the Victoria Health Warning, the smoker used to smoke 15 cigarettes per day, which has been now decreased to 11% because of the 40% Victoria Health Warning. So it means it's working. It means you don't need to call PAR risky. Victoria Health Warnings are still working. But if you look at in Nepal, the same, the Jaru, the product, so in Nepal it's a 90% Victoria Health Warning. So because of the Victoria Health Warning, you can see the smoker has decreased the consumption of the cigarettes per day from 11 to 5. That means 55% the reduction of the consumption by the smoker per day, the number of cigarettes. That's huge. The simple answer, why? Because the gambar is bigger compared to Indonesia. So overall, the larger the Victoria Health Warning, the larger the impact that we have and we will have. India is implementing the 85% Victoria Health Warning. 85, it's a huge population, second largest country in the world in terms of the population. And also burden of the tobacco. So the GATS, the report of 2017, highlight the very clear finding that the India the able to reduce the tobacco use, the prevalence of tobacco use from 34% to 28%. So Victoria Health Warning is one of the major interventions to achieve these results. So, Victoria Health Warning works in any settings. In Australia, the Victoria Health Warning here. This is a plain packaging. In plain packaging, these cigarettes, the jet, the club, is manufactured here in Indonesia. What does it mean? Indonesia export already manufactured the plain packaging, larger traffic health warning, export to other countries. What does it mean? Indonesia is very, very kind, very helpful to support other countries, to implement other countries' law, rules and regulations. But sometimes we feel we are quite behind to implement those rules, regulations in our own setting. So now the Pariski and Ibu Sandra and all the governments, they need your help. They need the help from all the professional civil society and or the individual to help them to increase the size and also to go for the plain packaging. In Myanmar, as I mentioned earlier, Myanmar just started the 75% Victoria Health Warning in last year. So in 1 year, the Myanmar Ministry of Health, they made a very good evaluation and found that Victoria Health Warning is working in their community. So the Minister of Health, I met him on 27th of February and he made a commitment and made a public announcement that he will sign a 90% Victoria Health Warning on 7th of June this year, that is next month. So the things are improving at the public health scenario very fast, especially in tobacco control. Tobacco control is not only for tobacco control. Tobacco control really helps to improve the system of public health. And then there is always a question, if you increase the size of Victoria Health Warning, the retailer, the business people, they would not support this initiative. But it's not true. It's not true even in the Indonesian settings. The most of the retailers, they do support Victoria Health Warning. In Nepal also, they do support the Victoria Health Warning. So it means the business community, they would be happy to implement governments, rules, and regulations. Wonderful study made by is done by the Muhammadiyya 2-3 years back. They did this the study among the tobacco farmers. And if you look at the results, the tobacco farmer is they are happy to support, they are happy to help the government and have a good tobacco control program in Indonesia. So what does it mean? It means there is the support from all segments of the community for the good tobacco control program in Indonesia and in the region. So in summary, pictorial health warnings are effective, they are cost effective, government has the capacity to increase the size, and now that you can see the Ministry of Health determination to increase the size. Very clear roadmap. So please, let's help Ministry of Health. Let's implement larger graph health warning to protect our children and the future of our children. What we need to do? Just look at this, very simple, it's a graphic, it's a real implementation. If we should not be concerned about the tobacco industry. Tobacco industry, they are already implementing rules and regulations of other countries. The Indonesian tobacco industry. So we should not be worried whether they will implement or not. Now, 40% Victoria Health Warning regulation was well implemented. And it has been, now if the government they increase the size to 75% or 90%, they will implement, they will follow. Because their role and the responsibility is to implement the government's rules and regulations. So we would like to really the help and support Ministry of Health to come up the regulation as early as possible, so that we can intervene the better the public health program in Indonesia. So again, if these things are happening in other countries, why not for Indonesia? Please, let's. I would like to request all of you, please call Pariski. What does it mean? It means let's help Pariski and team on people like that one. Let's help Usanda and the team for the tobacco control and also all here in the Ministry of Health. Please call. Just call, hello, what is happening on Victoria Health Warning? What type of support you would like to receive from us? Call them. If we don't call them, they will not get the support. Goal is to help them, not to only blame. We can blame the government. I blame my government always. Doesn't mean that I don't support. I bring the support to my government. Same thing. We should be as one community to help governments. We have to do this. Please call Ibu Sandra and please call the Paris team for this intervention. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pak Tanah. Sekarang kita akan mendengarkan bagaimana PHWI